Hey everyone, I hope you all are doing great. In today's video, we are going to be talking about scripted inputs in Splunk. So you must be wondering what is scripted inputs. So scripted input in short is you create a script to pull some data and then you send the data to Splunk for indexing. Okay, so that's all it is. There can be various requirements for using scripted inputs. For example, let's say you want to monitor some server where you cannot install Splunk forwarders, okay, so it can be a legacy server, and in that case you may need to create your own custom script to bring CPU and memory related data and then put that data into Splunk. So that can be one scenario. Or let's say you want to pull the data from some REST API or from any application for which you have to write some program, and then you want to index that data to Splunk. Okay, so basically you can just write a program, and in that program you can write any logic or any code to bring the data and put the data into Splunk. Okay, so one more scenario can be that you want to monitor some database, or you want to run some query on database, then whatever the result is, that result you want to put it back in Splunk. Okay, so that can be done as well. Now creating a script input is fairly easy in Splunk. All you have to do is you have to go inside the application in which you want to create scripted input. So for example, in this case I have just installed Splunk, and by default if you install Splunk, this is the architecture which is going to be, or the folder navigation which is going to be on Windows. So here I'm on Splunk. Under Splunk, go to etc, and then you can go to apps. Under apps, if you have installed your own custom apps and you want to keep a script there, then you can do that as well. In this scenario, I'm just going to keep application under a script under search application. So for that, go to search, and then you need to go to bin directory. Okay, so make sure you keep your script under bin directory. So here I'm gonna go to bin directory, and to save time, I have already created a Python program, so I'm just gonna show you this Python program. I'm calling it get some random data dot py, and let's just change it and let's call it get app login data dot py. Okay, so I have changed the name, and now let's open this and see what is the content which is inside this script. So actually the script is a very simple script. I haven't really written much code inside this. So all it is doing is it is just importing couple of modules, and after that it is just generating some random data. So the data is in JSON format. I'm also going to run this Python program and show you what will be the output when this program is run. So let's run this program and let's see what happens. Okay, so here you can see when I ran this, it has just given me one name, which is app underscore 2, and it is saying user logged in is 83. So I'm generating this data randomly. So if you run it again, it may return some different data. For example, it is now returning app 1 and it is returning user logged in is 4. Okay, so this is just some random data which I want to generate by running this script. And for that, this is a code which I have written. If you are interested, you can just use this code, or otherwise I know you may want to write your own code. So for that you need to know programming language, either Python, or you can write the code in shell script or any other programming language as well. Okay, so now let's go ahead and add this script in Splunk to get the data directly in Splunk. So for that, what we need to do is we need to go to settings, and then we need to go to data inputs. So when you want to read any sort of data, you need to go to data inputs. So that's the thumb rule. So now we are going to go to data inputs, and after that you can just go ahead and move to scripts. Okay, so there are various other ways as well to just go directly to this place, but yeah, this is one of the way as well. So here I can click on new local script, and then I'm gonna give the path of the script, and then so on. Okay, so let's see how it works. So here now you can see in the script path, you need to give the path where you have kept your executable. So for example, here I remember that I have kept Python script under apps search bin. Okay, so I'm gonna select this, and after you do that, it is going to show you a list of all the programs which are available here. So you can see these are all the Python scripts are available, and here you can see all of those script names here. So here we just need to scroll down and select the app which we have created, which is get app login data.py. Okay, and then in the interval you need to specify how frequent you want to run this script. So for example, let's say I want to run this script every 30 seconds or 20 seconds or 10 seconds. So for example, in this case I want to, let's say, run it every 10 seconds. So I'm just gonna say 10, and then you can click on next to move on to next page, and in the next page it is going to ask you what is the source type. So make sure if you have JSON data, you change it change the source type and select JSON. And if you have CSV data, then you can select those as well. Okay, so any kind of data you can just index in JSON. Now here we don't really need to make any changes. In index, I'm just gonna select main. If you want to create a new index, you can do that. And that's it. Let's click on preview. It is going to show you all the option or settings which you have selected. So everything looks okay to me. I'm just gonna go ahead and click on submit. Once we do that, now it is saying script has been successfully created. Okay, now we can click on start searching, and we should be able to, you know, start running our search query to see whether we are receiving the data or not. So let's see. Okay, now search query is running, and you can see we have already started receiving data. Okay, and again you can also notice here that we are having two fields. One is called name, other one is called user logged in. This is the same thing which I have shown you here on this when I ran this Python script here. Now what we can do is you can of course format the data like, you know, you format any other data. So you can use name, and you can use users logged in, and let's run it. Okay, now you can see it is showing you name and total number of users logged in. So this is the data which we were writing or which is being written every 10 seconds to Splunk, and that is the data which we see here. And now since you have the data here, you can perform any Splunk searches or Splunk command which you want to perform here on this data. So that's it in this video. If you have any query, feel free to write to me. One more thing I want to tell you before I go, that if you want to see, if you get any error, in that case you can go to index equal to internal, and then you can search for error. Okay, so when you search for error, if there is any error in running your script, in that case it is going to show those errors here, and you'll be able to know if there is, you know, if anything has gone wrong with your script. But in my case everything is okay. We are able to see the script's output, so we don't really see any error, okay, at least related to that program. So there are various errors available here as well, but it is for different thing which we don't really need to worry about at the moment. So that's it in the video. See you again in the next video.